Hello and welcome to this Scan to NAS Drive guide. Today we will set up one-touch scanning from a brother device to a Synology DS220j NAS drive. Your drive may differ, but the steps will be similar. If you have just purchased a NAS drive, complete the initial setup. This should be explained in your device documentation. Once the initial setup is complete, we'll create a user profile and file shares for the brother device. Open your preferred web browser and enter the IP address of your NAS drive. Enter a username that has admin rights. During the initial setup of the device, I created a user called brother with admin rights. Enter your username here, then click the blue arrow. Enter the password, then click the blue arrow again. Select the control panel icon. Select the shared folder icon. We're going to create two shared folders. The first is a folder for scanning receipts into. Select the Create option. The shared folder wizard starts. Name this folder Receipts. You can leave the description blank, leave the location as default, remove Restrict Access to Administrators Only. The account we make for the brother device will not be an administrator account. Select Next. In this example, I will not encrypt the folder. If you want to encrypt your folder, please see your NAS drive documentation. Select Next. Confirm the settings by selecting Next. The admin and brother user accounts are part of a group that have read and write access. Those users are able to view the scans in the newly created folders. Later, we will create an account for the brother device to use. Select Apply. Repeat this process for any other shared folder you would like to create. I will create one more folder called Work. Once completed, we have two folders ready for our brother device to use. It's now time to create a user account for the brother device. Select the user and group icon. Select Create. The user creation wizard starts. Here we create an account for the brother device to use. Enter a name for the brother device in this field. I suggest making it obvious this account is for the device and not a person. Make a note of this name. You will need this later. I do not need a description as the name makes it clear what the account is for. Enter an email address. This field is required if you want to send an account confirmation email to the user. I will use my own address for ease. You do not need to enter an email address if you untick the option to send a notification mail to the newly created user. Now enter a password for the user account or use the generate random password option. Make a note of this password, you will need it later. Click apply. Select if you want to send an email to the new user. you can choose to send the password in that email. And finally, if you want to allow the user to change their account password. The user account information is complete. Select Next. The user creation wizard gives you the option to add the user to groups. By default, the account will be added to the users group. There's no need to add the account to other groups. Select Next. We need to apply read and write permissions to the folders we have created for the brother device. Selecting this option will apply read and write access to both shared folders. Now the permissions are set, select Next. Leave this as default and select Next. Select the SMB option. Select Next. Leave these settings as default and select Next. Confirm the settings and select Done. You have now created an account for the brother device that allows scanning to the folders you have created in part 1. Remote access to these files is a feature of this drive. For more information, use the link in the description to Synology's instructions. Open a web browser and enter your brother machine's IP address in order to access its internal web server. If you see a button labeled Open Secure Login, please click it. This might send you to a security warning message. If it does, find and click the button or link similar to this one. This will reveal another button or link that you will need to click in order to continue. Despite any surrounding warning messages encouraging you not to continue, clicking it to access a brother machine is completely safe. Then type in its admin password and click the login button. Locate and select the scan option. Then select the scan to FTP / network option. Select the network option. Select the Submit button. From the navigation menu, click the Scan to FTP / Network Profile option. Select the profile you created. Give the profile a name. This name will also be visible to end users from the brother device. Next, enter the network folder path. To do this, enter 2 backslashes and then the node name of your NAS drive, followed by a single backslash and then the shared folder name. In this example, the node name can be found at the login screen of your NAS drive. You can use the IP address, but I recommend using the node name in case your NAS drive IP address changes. From the range of options shown here, decide how you want the brother device to present your scanned files. And if you want to protect the scan profile with a PIN code. It's now time to configure the authentication. If you are unsure of which authentication method to use, select the Auto option. Enter the username you created during the user creation wizard earlier. Enter the password you created during the user creation wizard earlier. Re-enter the password. Scroll to the bottom of the page and select Submit. It is recommended to let your brother device test your settings by selecting the Yes button. If your settings are okay, you will see the Test OK message. Repeat these steps to add the receipt's profile. If your settings did not work, you will see this or a similar message instead. For troubleshooting recommendations, please use the link in the description. In this section, we'll create the one-touch shortcuts. To set up the shortcuts, we will use the screen on the brother device. Select Scan. Select To Network. Select Work. Set to your preferred scan options. Select Save as Shortcut. Select OK. Choose where you want to save your shortcut. Delete the default name. Enter the name for your shortcut and press OK. Select the one-touch shortcut and press OK. You can now select this shortcut to scan to your NAS drive with a single touch. Repeat this process for your other profiles. Your profiles are now configured for one-touch scanning. If you configured remote access at the end of part 2, you will be able to access the scan folders from a web browser on Windows, macOS, or Linux machines. Or with a mobile device using the DS file app. Thank you.